Morning, good morning, ladies. Right, so a little backroom thing going on now. So I'm just about to start the Sunday stretch. So what I've done over this lockdown period, because people are feeling locked in, I give them, surrender to fitness, So I give them this stretching on a daily basis. I call it the daily stretch, but today we're doing the Sunday stretch, and it's all about getting you locked out while you feel locked in this lockdown. So this is a little backroom and also fly on the wall. So I've got a Zoom going on. I'm just about to admit someone in there, but what this will do as well, I'm gonna populate it on IGTV, on my YouTube channel, and also on my various platforms as well as my coaching platform as well. So if you wanna get on that, then we can start talking. Right, I'm gonna let you in. So we've got two people. Okay. So, it's coming in now. So what we're gonna do is we're gonna start the stretch, the Sunday stretch. Mental release, physical release, make you feel better. Optimum performance. All right then, good morning. Morning. Morning, Teresa. Morning, Nia.
Morning.
Good morning.
Good morning, everyone.
All right, we're gonna get started straight away because you guys have got the half nine as well. Okay, everyone all right? Awesome. Coffee. Right, so what we're gonna be doing, starting off, taking a seat. Does anyone have a foam roller? Or not? It doesn't matter? No? No worries. We won't use it. So I'm not gonna give adaptations either. So what we're gonna do is like this, feet flat in front of you, so you're kneeling. So I should really get in a better position here, so you can see what I'm doing. So you're going to be kneeling like that. You're gonna hug your knees, your legs, and then you're gonna lean in. So you're gonna lean in. So lean in to your thighs. You can hold your ankles, lean in a bit more if you want. I'm hugging them myself, so I'm leaning in. I'm just opening up my lower back. And we're gonna get to the point where you feel you can't squeeze in anymore. And we're gonna hold that pose. We're gonna hold that for 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. And then you're gonna release slightly. You're gonna take a deep breath in. And you're gonna hold your breath. And you're gonna move down, holding your breath. And we're gonna hold that breath for 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Release the breath and push yourself more into your body, into your legs. Opening up them hips, that lower back. And then from there, the feet are gonna go out, then they're gonna go wide, and then you're gonna put your fingers on the floor and you're gonna walk your fingers on the floor. Or your palms, whatever you've got on the floor. And you're gonna go to the furthest point where you feel the inside of your thighs getting stretched, your adductors. Also, your lower back is gonna be opening up as well. And then from here, your left foot is gonna be planted on the floor. So your hands are still out, your left foot is planted. And then what you're going to do is get your left hand and go right back. So your right hand is right in the middle of your legs. Your left hand is behind you, supporting you. And you're gonna put your palm flat and you're gonna collapse your elbow and you're gonna lean back. Still keep the hand draping on that floor as you lean back. And you're gonna feel your shoulder, your left shoulder, start to stretch where your clavicle is. And then what I'd like you to do is bring that straight leg that you've got, so your right leg, I want you to bend it, and I want you to place the knee on the floor. So you go into a 90-90 stretch. So your right leg now is at a 90 degree angle. Your body is now twisted, so you're feeling your obliques getting stretched. And your left leg now is also in a 90 degree angle, 90-90, while you're still keeping that left shoulder
open. And we're gonna hold that pose for another 10 seconds. Just breathing normally, breathing normally. And then you're just gonna swap your legs over and your arm over. So now you're on your left arm, you're gonna put your right arm where your left arm was in the opposite way, and just turn your legs the opposite way around. So you've now got a 90 degree angle on your left leg with your knee facing down, and then you've got a now 90 degree angle on your right leg with your knee, inside of your knee facing up. Inside of the left knee facing down, inside of the up, inside of the right knee facing up. And you want to get a nice lean back, so you feel that oblique, feel those hips opening up. And as you are in that position now, we're going to lie on our sides in that position, grab our right leg, our right foot, and we're going to pull it in. So your head is going to go right down on your shoulder, on your arm. And you're going to be pulling your ankle so that your heel is going up to your butt and you are stretching your quadricep. And we're going to hold that stretch for 3, 2, 1. And we want to be on the other side as well now. Same thing. So we're going to lie on our arm, shoulder, grab our elbow, our ankle on the other side, and just stretch the quadricep. So for me, that's incredibly difficult. But for you, maybe it's much more easier. And we're going to hold that for another 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. And from there, you're not going to make much of a move. You're just going to lie on your back. I'm going to get into a position where you can hopefully see. So you're going to lie on your back. And you've made the easy transition from the left side now, rolling onto your back. And you're going to raise your right leg. And you're going to grab your right leg, wherever you comfortably can, with your shoulders now trying to rest on the mat, on the floor, and pull on your leg to come back. And pull it as far as it will go without you aggravating, getting those fibers angry. So you're just gonna feel a nice pull, nothing too strenuous. And then you're gonna slowly, if you haven't already, bring your opposite leg down flat. So now you don't have a bend in your left knee, it's just straight. And then from there, your right foot is gonna come over and rest on your left thigh. And you're going to prop yourself up on your elbows. And you're going to put your left heel on the floor and lift yourself up. And we're gonna hold that for 3, 2, 1, and relax it. Just take a couple of deep breaths, And then 3, 2, 1, we elevate ourselves. And 3, 2, 1, and we're gonna relax. We're gonna relax the right leg on the floor, so flat on the floor. You're gonna then lie back down again, and the left leg is gonna come up. You're gonna grab the left leg, pull it back until you feel it become quite tight. Don't force it to go all the way back, just keep it nice and taut. Get that hamstring, that glute to be reactive. Bless you. And then you're going to put your foot on your right thigh. And again, prop yourself up, dig your right heel in the ground, and then lift yourself up. And we're gonna hold that for 3, 2, 1, relax. And again. 3, 2, 1, we raise ourselves up, And 3, 2, 1, relax. So again, we're just gonna lie on the floor and we're gonna bring both our feet level with each other as our knees bend, and we're gonna put our fingers directly underneath our heels. And we're gonna rotate the waist so that our fingers are traveling towards our heel. One side to the other, one side to the other. We're gonna mobilize ourselves. So get fluid, alternate sides, and you're transferring from one side to the other as you keep on going. Transfer one side to the other.
As I've got to say hello. Morning, Nick.
Transfer one side to the other. You keep on going. Every time you transfer the weight, you'll be able to go down just a little bit more. Unless your muscles now activating, getting stretched, allowing new, fresh, oxygenated blood in those cells, allowing that flexibility. Awesome. And now what we do is we have our right foot outstretched. So our right leg now is on the floor while our left leg is bent. And then what we're going to do is raise our left leg up, and our arms are going to go out to the side to support us, stabilize us. And your left foot, left leg is going to go right over your body. Now that your obliques, your hips have been opened up, you're now going into what's called a reverse scorpion. And we're going to hold the reverse scorpion for another 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. And then the left leg is going to go down, and then your right leg is going to come up, and your right leg now is going to rotate over your left leg. Both your hands are going to be flat still on the floor, and the reverse scorpion continues. Just feel your leg just wanting to drop down because your hips are just now opening up. Your glutes are opening up. And then what we do here is, from lying flat on our backs, we're gonna lie flat on our stomachs. Lie flat on our stomachs. And we're gonna have our hands either side of us as if we were just about to press up. And that's exactly what we're gonna do. We're gonna press up, we're gonna leave the thigh, and partially we're gonna leave the waist on the mat, and you're gonna be lifting your chin above your chest and performing what's known as a cobra. So we've gone from the scorpion to the cobra. Stretching the abdomen. Deep breaths as we continue. And then what I would like is for you to just sit on your heels. And from here, we're gonna take some deep breaths in. So, the first thing we're gonna do is breathe in for 4 seconds. We're gonna hold for 4 seconds, breathe out for 4 seconds. Hold for 4 seconds, and then breathe in for 4 seconds. So box breathing. So 3, 2, 1, 4 seconds in, 4, 3, 2, 1. Hold for 4, 3, 2, 1. 4 seconds, we breathe out, 4, 3, 2, 1. And then we hold again for 4, 3, 2, 1. Now we breathe in for 4 seconds. Hold for 4 seconds. Breathe out for 4 seconds. Hold for 4 seconds. Breathe in for 4 seconds. Hold for 4 seconds. Breathe out for 4 seconds. Hold for 4 seconds. Then we breathe in for 4 seconds. Hold for 4 seconds. Breathe out for 4 seconds. Hold for 4 seconds. And breathe as normal. And now get your knees a little bit more wider. And put your hands directly underneath your chin, directly underneath your chest. And now you are in what's known as a frog pose. So from the frog pose, what we're gonna do is we're gonna mobilize that frog pose. So we're going to, with the knees, with the hips, hinge over so that we also get our wrists being mobilized. So we're gonna go back and forth as we did with the trunk twist when we were lying on our backs, or the trunk rotation. So we're just mobilizing now, mobilizing. We're gonna go into two mobilizations. This is the frog mobilization, which we're gonna carry on doing for the next 10 seconds. And then after we finish this, we're gonna get into a position where we are on all our fours symmetrically, and we're gonna go into scap mobilization. So 3, 2, 1, just get on your fours. So bring your knees slightly more in. So now you're on your fours, you've got your clavicle in line, so both your shoulders are in line. Drop your chest. As you drop your chest, your elbows are going to be slightly less flexed, slightly more flexed, sorry. And then you're going to bring up your scapula. So back to the beginning again. So again, with that mobilization technique, you're just going to be mobilizing your scapula. What you'll find is your shoulder blades, they're going to want to pinch together eventually. You're gonna find this nice feeling when you sink in. It may feel awkward at first, but then it will start getting comfortable. And you'll feel your muscles just bundle together, work as one, as you mobilize the scapula. Awesome for that neck tension that we often get when we are sitting on our desks for quite a while being tense. So this will help that, as well as various other stretches, but this one is a big player. So from there, we're gonna get back into the frog stretch. So widen your knees and just now get those hips sat back. So your adductors are now stretched. So now you'll be able to sit a little bit more deeper and force yourself a little bit by pushing your heel, your palms. Push your palms as you can force yourself back so that you're sitting near enough close to your heels. And now what we're gonna do is another form of box breathing. So we're gonna go 8 seconds in, 8 seconds hold, 8 seconds out, 8 seconds hold. So in 3, 2, 1, 8 seconds in, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, 8, 7, 6. We hold, 4, 3, 2, 1. We blow out, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. And we hold for 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. And we go again, we breathe in 8 seconds. Hold. And we breathe out 8 seconds. And we hold 8 seconds. And then we breathe in again 8 seconds. And we hold 8 seconds. You should be able to push yourself a little bit more further towards your heels now. And now we breathe out 8 seconds. And we hold for 8 seconds. And last time, we're gonna breathe in for 8 seconds. And then we hold for 8 seconds. And then we breathe out for 8 seconds. And then we hold for the final 8 seconds. Awesome work. And what we do now is get on our knees and we put our leg out, put our hand on the hip that is stabilizing us. So the knee, whatever knee that you've got that's now supporting you, you put your hand on that hip. And then what you do, you put your opposing hand, so the leg that's outstretched, the hand goes up on the same side, and then you lean over, tilt. So now you're opening up your rib cage, opening up your lats, your obliques, your hips. And pressing your hip with the hand that is supporting you so that you're able to go down a little bit lower while still keeping upright. Kind of forcing the stretch. And 3, 2, 1, and we go back into that starting position, but we don't bring the leg in, the leg stays there, because you're now gonna flip your foot up, you're gonna turn to the side, you're gonna put your foot flat, and then you're gonna lean forward. Lean forward so that your chest is on your thigh. And then your foot is flat. So what we want is for your foot to come up now. So your toes now pointing to the sky, and you'll be able to straighten your leg a fraction, and you'll feel that in the hamstring. Nice and tight, but a nice tight, not an aggravated tight. It should be a smooth transitional pull that feels quite nice. So you're kind of stretching the muscles that don't normally get activated, but it feels nice because it's not aggravating near the sciatica, and it just feels nice because the blood flow is opened enough to give that nutrient, to give that medicine that the blood loves to give. And then we just come up. And again, we go back into that starting position, but now we swap the legs. So the knees now are together, and then the leg extends out. And from here, your hand is gonna go on your supporting hip, and the same arm on the same side as the outstretched leg is now gonna be outstretched. And then you're gonna go into your lean. All the while putting pressure on the supporting hip and allowing that stretch to activate, to open up. And just try and pressurize a little bit more that supporting hip. So you want to be pressing on the supporting hip and then just being able to go down a little bit more deeper. Opening up that oblique, opening up again that hip, and that lat, and the rib cage. Deep breaths in. And then from there, you're going to return, but don't bring your leg out. Don't bring your leg in, sorry. And then turn towards your foot. Have your foot elevated, planted, and then you're going to bend yourself over so that your chest is on your thigh. Stretching that hamstring, glute, hip, whilst the opposite leg has got a little bit of an adductor stretch going on as well. And then what I would like you to do now is bring your foot up so your heel embeds itself into the floor, and then you start to straighten your leg. Straighten your leg. And keep yourself absolutely centered so that you're not feeling an imbalance either side. Getting a wicked hamstring, glute, calf stretch. And while you're here, which I didn't do on the other foot, is grab your big toe and pull your big toe towards you. And it should come as no surprise, That's called the big toe stretch. And from there, you're gonna get yourself up again, keep the leg outstretched, and then bring the knees together again. And from here, you're going to put both your hands up, grab one of your elbows, push your elbow down so that your tricep is getting stretched, back of the arm. And you're gonna take a deep breath in and you're gonna hold your breath for 5 seconds. So we're gonna take a deep breath in now. And then we're gonna hold the breath. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Expel the breath, push the elbow down a bit more and lean to the side. And then breathe as normal. Breathe in through the nose, get a nice belly breath. So every time you breathe in, that belly should be protruding out. So you're breathing from the belly. And then breathe out through the mouth. Breathe in through the nose, open up the belly. And then breathe out through the mouth. And you feel your side just wanting to open up that little bit more. And then we straighten up slowly, arms go up again, and then we stretch the opposite arm, push the elbow down, get to a nice tight stretch, taut. And we're gonna take a deep breath in, and we're gonna hold that breath for 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, and we're gonna expel the breath, push the elbow down a bit more, and lean to one side as we're pushing the elbow down. Feel those lats open up, feel the hips open up. And then from there, bring your hands down, give yourself a one-armed hug, stretching the rear shoulder, and start pulsing that arm. Just pulse the arm. Back and forth, getting that rear delt to start opening up by the trap, getting those lats again flexed, feeling a nice tightness in the front delt where it meets the chest, the clavicle, opening up the rib cage as well as you breathe with rhythm. And then we're going to change sides, give yourself a self hug. And again, pulse it, opening up the rear delt, trap, lat, breathing in with rhythm. Breathing in with rhythm. And what I would like to do now is, we're gonna get again on our fours, and bring your right foot next to your hand. So your hands now should be parallel with each other, and you've got the right foot outside of your right hand. Your left leg is now trailing quite deep in the back. Your thigh should be on the floor, and your adductors, hip flexor, psoas should be opened. And your right hand should be pushing your right leg away. So you're getting a deeper adductor stretch. Make your spine neutral, so your lower spine may feel like it's arched. Just opposite that. Bring the opposite in. Oppose it. Chest goes up, head goes up. Breathe in as normal. And then release the right hand and start to trunk twist. And you're going into a T-hip opener. Opening up the hips, again the chest, lats, ribs, obliques, stomach, and then your hand's going to go back where it was in the beginning. Your right leg is going to now be pulled all the way back. Your left foot is now going to come right beside one of your left hand, sorry. And your hands should be again parallel. So remember, the same thing that we want. The trailing leg is gonna be pulled right far back, So you get a nice hip flexor stretch where the stomach meets the waist and the waist meets the thigh, hip flexor, and the front hip flexor. And then on the opposing leg, your left arm should be pushing away your left leg. So you're getting a nice adductor stretch, opening up your hips as well. Lower spine should feel neutral. And then what we're going to do is release one hand. So the left hand, we're going to release it, and we're going to go into a T hip opener. T hip opener. And then go back to where you was, and both legs now are equal, even. And we're going to go once again into the cobra, and in the cobra, we're going to hold it for the next 2 minutes. 3, 2, 1, and then we're going to go into the cat stretch. Lats popped out. And we're going to hold that for 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, and make your way slowly up. And we're going to finish off with the supine in tradition. Roll your arms out, the Sunday stretch. You have been stretched and optimized.
So, hey Chris, and all them workouts. Right, we are out.